Mustardo! My wondrous friends, how are you today? Nintendo recently published one of their regular earnings reports, which is always a fun time. I've done multiple videos on their ever-changing top sellers list, because better than anything, sales figures give us insight into what's working for Nintendo, what isn't working quite as well, and also what decisions they might make in the future. Though today, amidst all of the Switch's incredible, record-breaking successes, there's one game I'd like to draw attention to in particular. And that game is Luigi's Mansion 3. In previous sales discussions, I've already drawn attention to the fact that the game has been selling incredibly well. The second Luigi's Mansion was already a very big success on the 3DS, but 3 has cemented the series as a legitimately big and important one for Nintendo. I mean, it's generally understood that the more a series sells, the more important it is, right? Well, look at this number. I was already shocked by the game's success, but now that it's shuffled its way up toward 10 million units sold and will no doubt reach that number in the coming months, not to mention how it will also pass 10 million quite cleanly in the coming years, with 15 million lifetime sales not out of the question, I am positively flibberjambled. This is not one of those things where you go, oh hey look, that game did surprisingly well, that's cool, and move on. No, this is a huge deal. This could have a bigger effect on Nintendo's future plans than I think most people realize. Just for a quick comparison, to really hammer home how big of a deal this is, let's take a look at some of Nintendo's most beloved, iconic games that didn't sell as well as Luigi's Mansion 3, or will be outsold very soon. Install bases and casual versus core audiences and all that make all sales stories more complex than just numbers, but this is just to give you an idea. Okay, Super Mario Galaxy 2, Super Smash Bros. Melee, Mario Kart 64, every mainline Metroid combined, every single Zelda before Breath of the Wild. Yeah, that's right, Zelda has always seemed like one of Nintendo's big pillar series, one of the top dogs, a series that can never fail, that will be around forever because it just sells so darn well. Well, Luigi's Mansion 3 has got almost all of them beat. Again, specific context does matter to an extent. Gaming as a whole is getting bigger and bigger, and that affects sales potential. But I don't think I need to convince you that trouncing all past Zeldas of all things is a big deal for any series. As I've said before, to me, Luigi's Mansion has always felt like one of Nintendo's weirder series that no one plays, but that's simply not true. For whatever reason, it's really resonated with audiences. So I want to talk about what this success might mean for the series. In my video on Age of Calamity and what it meant for Zelda's story, I talked about how sometimes it feels like Nintendo operates based on flights of fancy. If they get a good idea, they'll do it, but they don't like to push things too far beyond that. They'll sit on ideas or even entire series for decades if they feel like it, even when utilizing what they've got would make all the sense in the world. But that's not how my mind works. When I see potential, I want to see it realized. If I worked at Nintendo and I saw a series that looked like it was really going somewhere, I would jump at the chance to give that thing wings so it could fly. And right now, the capitalist in me is looking at Luigi's Mansion and seeing a huge amount of business potential. Some might accuse me of being nothing more than a greedy fan who wants more, more, more all the time. But while that might be true to at least some extent, I mean, I'm not gonna kid myself, I'm mostly just interested in all this from a business perspective. I love the idea of being one of those big, important decision makers, trying my best to chart a course for a property so that it can see the most success possible. Will I ever actually be in that position? Maybe not. But that doesn't stop me from pretending. And that is why I am here today doing this unusually long intro. I don't know what Nintendo's plans are for Luigi's Mansion, if any, but I honestly believe they've got a great opportunity here. The iron is red hot right now, and they just need to strike it. Here's how I think they should do that. My plan for this iron strikage comes in four parts. The way I see it, everything a game company like Nintendo does when it comes to any given series comes down to two primary goals: making money and growing the audience to make more money later as well. I frequently get on Nintendo's case for focusing a little too much on that first thing and not enough on the second one in some cases, so you can bet that most parts of my plan offer differing combinations of the two. And the first part of my plan is the most basic, but perhaps the most important of all. Mario. Zelda, Smash, Pokemon, these are all very big, very popular Nintendo series. But what else do they have in common? Because they're so popular, they all have titles in production at all times. At any given time, you can bet that Nintendo has got a new 3D Mario, a new 3D Zelda, a Smash, and sure as sugar, a new Pokemon in the works. The company has realized that these series are worth pumping a lot of resources into, and every system needs at least one of each. There are, of course, a couple of weird outliers that challenge the idea of financial success leading to more consistent projects. Series that sell quite modestly, at least compared to many of Nintendo's other series, but still have games in the pipeline at all times. But I don't want to get into a whole bunch of arguments about those series and what kinds of sales constitute financial successes and all that. So all I'm really trying to say is that most often, the big sellers are more likely to get consistent entries. Pikmin 1 and 2 perform poorly, Nintendo takes nearly a decade to make 3 and is hesitant to make 4. Splatoon, a brand new IP, sells 5 million on a dying console? We want Splatoon 2 on Switch and we want it now! And throw in Splatoon 3 after a few years while you're at it. If it makes money, keep it coming. If it doesn't, then we'll think about it. So now that Luigi's Mansion has very firmly established itself as a series with a ton of sales potential, I think you see what I'm getting at here. No 6.5 years between entries, and certainly no 11.5 years. And before you say it, because people always say it, no, I'm not suggesting they start churning out Luigi's Mansion games every year or two. Nothing to reduce the quality of the games, obviously. And I'll admit, there is some element of specialness when there are only a small handful of games in a series. Each one can feel quite a bit more unique and memorable. And you can't just magically pull a bunch of new mechanics and ideas out of a hat, you've got to be inspired to a degree. That's why these would still be reasonable development cycles. I would expect at least 3 years between titles, maybe even up to 5 in extreme cases. Though really, if you've already got the engine and everything set in place, sequels really shouldn't take too long. But the point is that regardless of exact dev time, the projects are always moving. There's always a team working on the next one, coming up with ideas and themes and locations. Not a Nintendo system will go by without at least one Luigi's Mansion game, every once in a while too. In this scenario, assuming future Nintendo systems are all hybrids and are all as successful and healthy as the Switch, the company gets to continue making money on Luigi's Mansion, fans get to keep enjoying it, and by riding the momentum instead of allowing exposure and interest to lapse somewhat, they can continue to grow that fan base. And seeing as they just decided to purchase Next Level Games and the studio is already expanding, I do think this just might be the perfect time to assign a dedicated team to the IP while the rest of the studio works on other projects. The runaway sales of 3, the new acquisition, the timing could not be more perfect. Now, before we wrap up this point, I could see someone arguing that even with reasonable dev cycles, the series could suffer from creative burnout if working on new games at all times is a requirement. Like I said, good games don't happen by magic. But to that, I've got 2 things to say. 1, Luigi's Mansion has got so much potential. There's no limit to the kinds of places Luigi can go and the kinds of ghosts he can fight. I come up with new ideas all the time. And 2, I don't feel the worry of creative burnout should necessarily limit output. That's letting a problem that might not even be real stop you from doing what you want to do. 2 games a decade is not a huge ask, and even if burnout did occur, what if we got 3 amazing games before the team realized they needed a break? I say try it and see if it works before you assume that it won't. I'm not gonna stop myself from eating Brussels sprouts just because I might get tired of them and need a break in the future. I'm going to enjoy them and experiment with cooking them as much as I want and only stop if and when I reach that point. Alright, so we've set Luigi's Mansion up for the future. There will be no more giant gaps between releases. A new one is always coming. But that's a long-term plan. A true businessman doesn't want to just sit around for 3 to 5 years waiting for the next product to drop. He wants to find a way to capitalize on what he's got now. So, what's part 2 of my plan? I'm really gonna scare some people off talking like this, but the next part of my plan involves capitalizing on Luigi's Mansion 3's install base. Traditionally, the term install base is used to describe consoles sold, as each of those consoles opens up the possibility for a customer to buy games for it and thus generate money. But in this age of downloadable content, and let's not forget monetization as a whole, each individual game potentially becomes a monetization platform of its own. Nintendo has decided to monetize many of the Switch's best-selling games further with paid DLC packs. Once again, there are some really weird exceptions like Super Mario Odyssey and Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which would each make $100 million overnight with some simple paid DLC. Really, not sure what's going on there. But overall, it's clear that Nintendo is no longer shy about the idea. They like DLC now. And just about 10 million units of Luigi's Mansion 3 are now installed in people's collections. So naturally, part 2 of my plan is giving those people some DLC. One common complaint about the game is that it feels like it could have been just a little bit longer. Sounds like as good an opportunity as any to release some nice, meaty story DLC. It could be a mini campaign that takes place after the story concludes, or just somewhere in the middle. It could take place in a brand new locale next to the hotel, or it could utilize what's already there. Whatever the case, just giving us a good chunk more will do wonders, I think. And as with all DLC, it's a chance to spice the game up with some unusual ideas and baddies that didn't quite fit with the main story. And with nearly 10 million copies of the game out in the wild, I think it's all but guaranteed that at least a couple million of those people are gonna be willing to shell out for such a DLC pack, which would make the DLC even more financially successful than some other Nintendo games are all on their own. Additionally, this gets people playing the game again, gets them talking about it, sharing stuff on social media. It establishes that even between titles, Luigi's Mansion can be a big, fun new thing for people to get excited for. The more exposure, and the more frequent that exposure, the better. But Arlo, you might be saying right now, are you forgetting that Luigi's Mansion 3 already did get a DLC pack? No, I am not forgetting. It got some multiplayer DLC, and I gotta tell ya, this is one area where I feel the developers swung and missed. Don't get me wrong, it's cool that the game has multiplayer modes at all, and this DLC was clearly their attempt to support the multiplayer Luigi's Mansion scene. But either Nintendo didn't want them to do more with the idea, or they didn't quite get how to actually get people wanting to play together. Right out of the box, Scarescraper is a cool idea, and I did have a little fun with it. I mean, I love co-op stuff. So most of my time with Splatoon 2 was spent playing Salmon Run with my friends. Those were some of the best times I've had on my Switch, and what really kept us playing was the progression and reward system. Grinding our way up to higher ranks and earning gear was a great excuse to just do one more run, even if it was already 2 in the morning. Then more recently, my co-op itch has been scratched by Monster Hunter Rise. Playing with friends is unendingly fun and satisfying because there's always something to be working toward, always something to do or collect. I absolutely love the idea of having the same experience, only with the awesome Luigi's Mansion gameplay I've been in love with for decades. But no such system exists in Luigi's Mansion 3. It's all very basic without anything to really drive you forward beyond some achievements. It's just kind of something to pick up and mess around with, and then you're done. And I'm sorry, but that ain't how you create a lasting multiplayer experience. The game's got mini-games as well, but that's also not going to keep too many people coming back for more. And all the DLC added was more mini-games and some costumes for Scarescraper. Not really the kind of support I think most people were hoping for. I mean, it's cool if they just don't want to turn multiplayer Luigi's Mansion into a bigger thing, but considering they included Scarescraper and created this multiplayer DLC at all, that makes me think they would enjoy that. And maybe they just don't know how to do it? I don't know. But you can bet that the third part of my plan is to amp up all this multiplayer stuff. Start with a free update that brings at least a basic leveling system to Scarescraper, along with the ability to spend your earned money on cosmetics and emotes and stuff. Like really basic online multiplayer fare. As with Splatoon, the update should also give people way more custom options when playing with friends, so you can enjoy the game however you want. Just enough stuff to get people excited to play again. If that stuff doesn't end up doing much for the game, then alright, maybe it was too little too late, at least you tried. If it does work, then there you go, start developing even more stuff for it, maybe even monetize it further. I know Luigi's Mansion ain't gonna be the next Fortnite or nothing, but I think they've got an opportunity to make the game an even better value proposition and draw in even more new people. The bigger something is and the more people are talking about it, especially now in a time when streamers reign supreme, the easier it is to become even bigger than that. Think of it in terms of gravity. The higher a stellar object's mass, the more it can pull into itself, which makes it bigger, which makes it pull in more stuff, etc. And I think even a little extra work in the multiplayer department could go a long way for our green ghost hunting friend. The final part of my plan is perhaps the most traditionally capitalistic of all. We've ensured that more Luigi's Mansion games are in the pipeline, we've started re-monetizing the one that's currently in people's hands, and we've made an attempt to relaunch the multiplayer scene. We've done every game-related thing we can think of. So now it's time to start thinking beyond games. And this is an area where Nintendo has been weirdly hesitant and inconsistent over the years. They love capitalizing on nostalgia, especially when it comes to Mario, and yet they do not do nearly as much with their properties as other media companies. Things have certainly improved since I was a kid, back when any Nintendo merchandise was a rarity. The company is pushing a lot of Mario stuff, and other series get little toys and limited edition stuff sometimes. And now there's a Nintendo theme park in Japan, and they're finally making a Mario movie, so that's certainly something. But for most of their IPs, they dole out merch very selectively and make these kinds of decisions at a snail's pace, even when it comes to a sales juggernaut like Animal Crossing. 30 million copies in a year, and still the merch is all super special limited edition. We're only making a few thousand of these, you got 4 seconds to pre-order before it's gone. And I'm sorry, but that is not how you do things in the corporate world. What have I been trying to say this whole time? If the iron's hot, strike it. If you've got an IP that's selling like hotcakes, you branch out that IP. I know Nintendo's been weird about which games get new amiibos and which don't. Like, they want to keep selling a few of them sometimes, but don't really want to commit to anything. But I say, if you're making that Luigi's Mansion 3 DLC pack, give the people some cool new amiibo as well. And that's just the start. Why are there no Luigi's Mansion toys out there? There are some fancy figures and plushies and stuff here and there, but we need some nice, basic toys to stick on the shelf at Target. Stuff that's prominently displayed and readily available. Will kids really buy Luigi's Mansion toys? I don't know, but I want to find out. I mean, the characters are really fun and colorful and just a touch spooky, and I think the style is very appealing. And does basic, bog-standard Mario really need like 50 different toys all to himself? You can't spare one or two to try and grow some of your side properties? Then you've got that holy grail of multimedia franchises, the show. I know a lot of people are iffy about Mario characters appearing in a show or a movie with voice acting and all that, but I am certain that you could make a terrific animated adaptation of Luigi's Mansion. You've already got a great cast of characters with potential for more, you've got a good basic premise, neither Mario brother has to talk a whole bunch outside of small phrases if you don't want them to, it would be perfect! Animation has gotten so much better and cheaper over the years, and I've seen some incredibly junky kid shows with really decent CG. If they can get a show, a giant Nintendo property can get a show. Sonic Boom got a show, and that game was awful. Rabbids got a show, and let's just say I don't think people were exactly begging for that one. A show is not something where you just sit around and hope it falls into your lap. You don't wait until a property is already huge and then a show just materializes. A show is something you create proactively to both monetize and market your product. That's what Pokemon did, and their show is what launched their games to such heights. People like the initial product, they watch the show's successful. People see the show first and learn about the product, then go buy it. Both are successful. It's more money, it's more exposure, and even if it doesn't end up becoming a huge hit, I say it's still worth a shot. And at the very least, you're gonna make the pre-existing fans happy if you do it right. Though really, I don't think a Luigi's Mansion show would have a problem being seen. Just look at the cutscenes already in the games and you can see how good a show would look. You can see how funny and fun it has the potential to be. People really connect with this world. The grown-ups like Luigi because they know him from when they were kids and they know he's safe. The kids like it all because it's silly and spooky, but not so spooky their parents won't let them play it. And even deeper than that, Luigi's Mansion offers a more grounded, realistic, and consistent view of the Mushroom Kingdom, and I think that's one of the things that makes it so appealing. If a show leaned into that aspect and really developed these characters, I think it would resonate with fans and newcomers alike. But hey, whatever it is, show, toys, posters, Fortnite skins, napkins, whatever, do more with the property. Don't wait for opportunities to come to you and only release merchandise sometimes when you feel like it. Jump on this. Because Luigi's Mansion is bigger than it has ever been. And I truly believe it has the potential to be consistently brought up in conversations about Nintendo's massive tentpole IPs. Mario, Mario Kart, Pokemon, Zelda, Animal Crossing, Smash, Luigi's Mansion. And here's what I want you to think about more than anything. Okay, you ready for this? If the series doesn't have the potential I'm suggesting, then I have no idea why 3 is doing so well right now. It doesn't have the sheer, comfortable familiarity of Mario, or the everlasting cultural phenomenon status of Pokemon, or the timeless, super accessible gameplay of Mario Kart, or the epic scope of Zelda, or the ravenous competitive scene of Smash, or anything like that. There is absolutely no reason Luigi's Mansion 3 has sold this well beyond it just being a game that people think is cool. Have you ever thought of that before? Is that not incredible to you? Does that not say something about how appealing the series is and how much potential it has just at a base level? If you look at the list of Switch's best sellers, this game doesn't really fit. And yet, there it is. A relatively short, primarily single-player experience about ghosts in one spooky building is one of the system's most successful games. Ooh, ouch! Ah, I burned myself! Don't get too close to that iron right there. It is very hot. So what do you think about this? Do you think I'm going way overboard here, or would you like to see Luigi's Mansion become a big franchise as well? Do you think it's possible that Nintendo actually acquired Next Level Games with the exact intention of making releases more consistent? Are we gonna get Luigi's Mansion merchandise and tie-ins that I haven't even considered? Will the 10-episode first season of Luigi's Mansion come exclusively to Netflix this fall, become a critical darling, then fail to get renewed, which is apparently the best-case scenario with Netflix? Could the world be on the cusp of the most epic Luigi revolution we could ever dream of? Will Luigi's Mansion replace Pokemon as the highest-grossing media franchise of all time? No. But it's fun to dream.